Shalom Chavrim, I'm Stephen Ben-Nun. You're watching Israeli News Live. Very troubling news coming out of Syria right now. According to several articles that I've run across already in the Russian language, also in the Polish language, and that is that Russia has actually engaged a U.S. drone over the skies of Syria, actually shooting it down over the Mediterranean itself. This article right here that was on dnr-hotline.ru states here in the English language, the Russian air defense complex S-300, probably they say here the S-400, located in the Syria, opened fire for an unknown purpose at the Russian naval base in Tartus, or at least in the direction of it is really the way it should be translated. This was reported by eyewitnesses living in the port city of Tartus, Syria. Syrian bloggers write that the Russian anti-aircraft missile system S-300 launched a missile in the direction of the Mediterranean Sea. Initially, the information was published in social networks, and the comments to the post of a local resident confirmed that they saw and heard the launch of the rocket. A friend who lives near the port just confirmed that it was the S-300 missile. Russia intercepted something over the Mediterranean Sea, and said Syrian blogger Ali Hamdan. It is known that our ships and bases in Tartus cover the S-300 and S-400 SAMs, which of the systems produce missile. It is virtually impossible to determine visually. Recall that the sea base, the point Tartus, has been intensively. That's the article that we got there. Just to kind of give you an idea here on the screen and behind you, we've got Syria right here, Damascus to the south. Tartus is right here where the little red dot is. But I've also got another article that on the Russian language that says from Latvia to Idlib, there is claims that Russia has shot down in the last 24 hours six drones. We're going to go into that in just a moment. But here's what's really interesting. The U.S., and this is coming from Brasko Aad, he says Russian air defense shot down the EQ-4 Global Hawk over Tartarus last night. The Americans now come in with this story. And this was on, I forget which channel this was actually on here, but it says they're claiming that the Global Hawk drone crashes on the way back to Beale Air Force Base over California. I actually listened to the news broadcast on this. So the U.S. is trying to cover it up, just like they've never said anything about the three Americans that were killed there inside of Syria near Aleppo. Again, U.S. trying to cover up these stories here, and I think the reason why they're trying to cover up the three Americans that were killed is because allegedly they were very close to ISIS, and this may have been why the U.S. actually shot down the SU-22, because the SU-22 was bombing the ISIS militants there in the area. So it could have been that the U.S. was backing ISIS. Don't really know. The report that I read in Russian said that it was actually the ISIS militants that killed, or the radical groups as they call them, that killed the three U.S. servicemen that were there. Again, another article right here, and this one here on EER.ru says, the title says here, Russian S-300 hit an unidentified object off the coast of Syria. Again, same situation. They're also claiming the EQ-4 Global Hawk is what was taken down from this. And this was from an insider in the Pentagon that was reporting this. So the Pentagon, according to this article here, has admitted that they lost a $222 million drone as to the results of an S-300 missile defense system that was shot down by Russian Russians, that is. This article right here is the one that was in the Russian language that came out today that claims that, that's riafan.ru, that is claiming that Russia has taken out six drones. Very serious situation, friends, over Syria there. And you know that this is really causing things to escalate and escalate very rapidly. I also come across this article as well. Very troubling indeed. It was on actually on livejournal.com. Mike LE1.livejournal.com published this video here. And in the Russian language, it says after Ukraine, the U.S. creates an analog of the Nazis Azov in Syria. We need to create those storytellers who will translate our words in a different way, he writes. As soon as somewhere, instead of the word hello, we'll say Heil. Now that we are waiting for, from there, we will begin our great revival. And as you can see, in the photograph here on your screen, they're all doing a Hitler salute. It's the same things we were seeing inside of Ukraine. Very troubling situation. And of course, what's caught my attention about all these things that I wanted to share with you guys is the fact that the Vatican has just met here on the 13th of June. The Vatican itself was meeting with Israeli authorities there, and they were meeting there about enforcing Article 10, paragraph 2 in the Israeli agreement of 1993. Now, what's troubling about this is that agreement that was signed in 1993 used to be kept very secret. This is back there when they were having the Oslo Accords, when everybody was going up to Norway and was believed by President Clinton at the time that this was some great deal for Middle East peace for the Palestinians. Well, the Palestinians have just been a front from the beginning. The Vatican has had a desire to get a hold of Israel from the very beginning. And this is why when I look at the particular scripture that, I've shared so much with you guys, and that is, let's see, get to it right here, from Daniel chapter 11, verse 40, this is what troubles me right here, is that we find out, it says, at the time of the end, shall the king of the south, now they have on there push at him in English, but it's actually push with him, and the king of the north shall come against him, or over him, literally, like a whirlwind, or like a storm, with chariots, with horsemen, with many ships, and he shall enter into the countries, and shall overflow and pass over. Now that's what I'm seeing right now. The Vatican has met with Israeli authorities. The king of the south, the king of the south, which is Melech HaNegev, the king of the Negev desert, that's the Israelis. That's an Israeli leader. Isn't it odd that they actually anointed, Mike Evans anointed Prime Minister Netanyahu back when he was like 21, 22 years old, when his brother Jonathan was killed during the rescue operation of the hijacked plane there. Jonathan was killed, and then Mike Evans, according to the story, anoints Netanyahu, prophesies over him that he'll be Prime Minister not once but twice over Israel. I want to think that that was genuine, but sometimes I just don't know. Could it have just been a setup? Because you don't anoint a man to be a prime minister. You anoint him to be a king. And if he was anointed with oil and prophesied over, whether it be a true king or a false king, he's still a king over Israel. He is the king of the Negev, or the king of the house of Judah. That's what he really is. And of course, the king of the north is also of the house of Israel, the northern kingdom, which is none other than the dispersed of Israel that have formed together, Ephraim and Manasseh. Remember, Jacob crossed his hands. When he crossed it, that's through the cross, he prophesied and said that they would be like fish on land, showing that they would be Christians. So you're looking at the Vatican, the European Union, the United States, and Great Britain. But it's a Melech HaTzafon, a hidden king. In other words, the identity, to really know the true identity of that hidden hand that is in behind all of this is very difficult to tell. Is it some kind of alien being or something that the Vatican wants to baptize, that they're going to bring out as a Messiah, an Antichrist? Who knows? But the thing is they're meeting, and what are they meeting for? To really push forward the negotiations pursuant to the fundamental agreement between the Holy See and the State of Israel in 1993, Article 10, Paragraph 2, which was for no other reason but to combat anti-Semitism. That's why we have all the war here in the Middle East. And if the King of the South is pushing with the King of the North, Israel is actively involved in trying to overthrow the Syrian government, actively involved in trying to bring down Iran, and will be actively involved and overthrowing Lebanon as well, mainly Hezbollah, which most Israelis would probably say Hezbollah has got to go because there's a lot of problems there. But when it comes to Syria, I just don't see that, my friends. I can't see that. President Bashar al-Assad has been the most tolerant president of our time for Syria in modern days. And the odd thing is, you know what it reminds me of is Ben-Hadad. Ben-Hadad, back in the days of Israel, was murdered. And he was the good king. He's the one that even Elisha liked. The prophet Elisha, who took the place of Elijah. And the man was sick and thought he was going to die. He sends for Elisha, and Elisha tells him, you'll recover. But then Elisha weeps. Why? Because the very man that had come to find out whether or not he would survive or not was the man that was going to murder him. And he did. And he was the wicked king, and he's the one that did all the evil to Israel. And that's what's going to happen in this day as well. You're going to find out that they're going to do away with President Bashar al-Assad, and they're going to bring in the wicked government that's going to bring down Israel. You think it's for Israel's good. It won't be for Israel's good. Well, sure, they'll build the third temple, all right. There's already Knesset members meeting with Adnan Oktar, the Turkish so-called proclaimed caliphate, or Mahdi. He's the Arabic idea of a messiah. None of this is true. This is nuts, guys. This is they're going to set up a fake millennial reign. They're going to bring about a false messiah. The Jews are going to fall for it. But you know, let me tell you something. Joel Bannerman, and let me show you something real quick. I put this up and I was going to share this with you. I did for you guys that are watching live on Twitter right now. But I wanted to show you something. When we think about the King of the South and the King of the North, just to clarify, when Daniel speaks of the King of the South, he doesn't call him Melek Hadarum. The real word for the word South on the compass, by the way, this is a compass, that's the only one I could find that would show you what the Hebrew words for North, South, East, and West are. Tzafon is the word for North, but it's also for the word for hidden. But the word for South is Darum, not Negev. Negev is a Negev desert, so we know it's an Israeli leader. But the Tzafon is that hidden one. That is the ones, that is the house of Israel that is dispersed throughout the world and nobody knows, but they've worked their way into power. Now, I'm all for my Jewish brothers and sisters. You have to understand, I'm not against the Jewish people. I love them. I am Jewish. My mother is from the house of Judah. My father, his family is from the house of Israel. We were Moroccan Jews on my father's side. My mother's side is European Jews. All right, so I still love my people, but the thing is what I don't love is when I watch that Hatzafon, that Melech Hatzafon, the king of the north, working with a king of Israel to bring in an antichrist, that I don't like at all. Now, Joel Bannerman, the late Joel Bannerman and Barry Chalmers, I knew Barry Chalmers very well. We spent a lot of time talking together, uncovering what the Vatican's plots were, but Joel Bannerman spoke extensively on this. He was the one, him and Barry Chalmers exposed the Vatican's plot of 1993 under the former president and former prime minister of Israel, Shimon Peres, who actually married, he was like Ahab bringing Jezebel inside of Israel. Oh, it's terrible. Anyway, let me share with you something that Joel Bannerman said. He says, it can't be that the Vatican is only interested in the access to the holy sites in Jerusalem. They already have that, as well as the legal jurisdiction under Israeli law. So he goes on to say, when these holy sites were under the jurisdiction of the Jordanians from 1948 to 1967, no pope demanded the internationalizing of Jerusalem. But do you know they're doing it now? They're calling for an international city. And the Vatican is going to be over it. This is why they've already divided the land. People are talking about a two-state, a one-state, and all this kind of stuff. It is a two-state solution. They've already divided the lands, friends. You think that it's not divided? It's been divided. Why do you think all the infrastructure was put in already? Why do you think Google Maps is now going by the, 1993 Oslo Accord lines, armistice lines, the pre-1967 border? Why do you think President Trump, as many people that love him, and I've always appreciated his stand with Israel, but you know what? President Trump's stand with Israel is not really a good stand. It's to help fulfill the Vatican's desire to be able to take over Jerusalem. That's why the White House had the Golan Heights removed from Israel. You didn't know that, did you? Palestinians are going to get the Golan Heights, by the way. Not Bashar al-Assad, not President Assad of Syria. They're going to try to kill that man unless Russia gets him out of there. Barry Chalmers also writes on this right here. He says here, they know this isn't the end of the story the Jewish God had in mind, but that doesn't mean they won't try to engineer their own ending to the story. He's talking about the Vatican. This is under the title of the Vatican Roman Catholic's version of the events is this. And then he writes this right here. So what if it is fraudulent? Doesn't matter. That is the game plan. And that is what the matters is. And that is what Israeli Jews need to be better informed about. It is important, Joel writes, for everyone to know what the Vatican has up its sleeve, because it directly relates to our existence and our future destiny as an independent nation. He says, this is very important. Powerful force, this is scheming to get control of the old city of Jerusalem, so you better know why and how the Vatican intends to do this. That's exactly what Joel wrote. You know, this man died, I think, at the age of 56. Barry Chalmers told me, he said, Steve, he said, they tried to murder me so many times in Israel. He said, they tampered with the brakes on my car. They failed. He said, I ended up in emergency rooms. They tried to kill me when I was in the hospitals. He said, they're still trying to kill me. He said, even though I fled to the United States, me and Barry only lived a couple of hours apart from each other in the state of Florida. And his daughter, I think, believes that they actually finally killed him. Watch what else he says here. This is Joel Bannerman. And Joel Bannerman and Barry Chalmers were very good friends. The Vatican has attempted to obtain control of Jerusalem, which started with the Crusades, for them to convince the world that the Messiah they put on the world stage is going to be accepted as genuine. They need to perform this play in the Old City. The story of this production is this Messiah will merge the three monotheistic religions. Sound familiar? Usher in peace and harmony in the world, and solve the Middle East conflict. Wow, doesn't that sound interesting too? The location for this production will be none other than the old city of Jerusalem. This so-called Messiah that will be proclaimed will be false one, and it will insist that by having a world government, i.e. the United Nations, the world peace and harmony will be ushered in. This will be a lie and a fraud, but never mind, our world reality isn't important. Public perceptions are. Now, you guys may not be able to see the blue because bad choice of color. I apologize for this. Let me read what he says and what I wrote here in the blue, or highlighted in blue. The end results are the stripping of Israel's sovereignty as an independent nation, giving way to a regional bloc of nations. That's the danger. Watch what he says here again. The end results, in other words, what the Vatican is wanting to do, is stripping of Israel's sovereignty as an independent nation, giving way to a regional bloc of nations. What did President Trump say about this? Their new founded partners, Saudi Arabia is one of those, Turkey another one. And then when they redo these nations in the Middle East after they destroy them with war, Jordan being another one. So the end result is stripping of Israel's sovereignty as an independent nation, giving way to regional bloc of nations in the Middle East. Israel will be pressured to accede to these demands by all world bodies as a superpowers on the claim that this is the only way to solve the Middle East conflict. In order for to the Jews to go along, they will convince them that with the Messiah having appeared for the Jews, it is time to start rebuilding the third temple, what they call Solomon's Temple. This was, by the way, is on redmoonrising.com. Just look up Joel Bannerman, Red Moon Rising. You'll find the article. I'll have it in the links below. Friends, this is serious. And this is exactly what's going on. And then you hear Knesset member Rabbi Yehuda Glick speak about the building of the Third Temple. And look at all the different dignitaries of the Knesset that have gone and met with Adnan Oktar, the self-proclaimed Mahadi, that writes these beautiful articles that the Jewish people have just really fell for, hook, line, and sinker. They just swallowed the whole thing because he says he's looking for the building of the third temple and they believe that the Jews should pray on the Temple Mount. Well, sure they should be allowed to pray on the Temple Mount. Well, why shouldn't they be allowed? But you don't understand. They're trying to orchestrate a fake millennial reign. The Vatican is the chief architect behind it. This has everything to do with the Mekadeshit that they created in Israel. Mekadeshit, by the way, is a Hebrew word that the Vatican used, by the way, for bringing the three monotheistic religions together. And Mekadeshit in Hebrew means engaged or espoused. In other words, they're trying to marry the three monotheistic religions and they're going to bring some kind of alien. I think it's going to be an alien Antichrist. I really believe that they are trying through this CERN and all this kind of garbage that they're working on out there. They're trying to reach into another dimension, or maybe they've already done it. These devils that are here on this earth that are incarnated in human bodies. Yeah, that's probably where their alien Antichrist is going to be. Maybe one of these little shapeshifter devils. I've seen it in a vision what they're planning on doing. I know what they're up to. They're going to bring this in and proclaim that to be Israel's Messiah. They're going to set in their thousand-year millennial reign. My wife's going to be speaking on that, by the way, in Atlanta about transhumanism. Yeah, they through these nanobot technology that they have, they can take and put this through you, whether it be through your vaccines, the medications you're taking, but they put these nanobots in through the chemtrails and everything else. And you know what? They're going to turn that stuff on, and eventually, as long as you go with the program and they hook your brain up to some supercomputer, they will be able to give you life that'll seem like it's endless. They think they can actually do this for 1,000 years. Well, maybe they could, if the Lord allowed them, if the true Messiah, Yeshua, if he actually allowed them to do it, maybe they could. But that just reminds me, when the Bible says in Revelation that, you know, that when he comes, he'll rule with a rod of iron. Well, you know their idea of a ruling with a rod of iron is? Their rod of iron is missiles. Yeshua was never like that. Jesus was not like that. I'm troubled about what I'm seeing. I'm very troubled. I'm Stephen Bannoun. You're watching Israeli News Live. I'm asking you, friends, pay close attention to what's happening. And if there's any way, if you would like to support the broadcast we're doing, we do appreciate your support in doing this, because you're the ones that help me keep spreading the word. I'm Stephen Bannoun. You're watching Israeli News Live. Visit our website, israelinewslive.org. If you're watching on YouTube, you can donate if you'd like to go to the little link we have there just above the subscribe button. Shalom.